So please give a huge round of applause for Rick Andrews and Elana Fishbein! Yeah! I'm Rick, this is Elana. We're from Magnet Theater in New York City. We're so happy to be here for you guys. Can we just get a suggestion of any word?
Snack.
What was that?
Snack.
Smack?
Snack.
Snack. Snack. Thank you. Snack.
It's just not an appropriate snack, sweetheart.
I feel I want to do what I want to. I need sugar to get my energy up to do my homework.
These are commercial sugar cubes. These are going to horses. I'm putting these in my car and I'm driving them down to the stables.
I feel like sometimes I could be like a horse because I can run like the wind.
That's adorable.
Mommy,
what's wrong with your pretzel sticks? I got you pretzel sticks.
Ugh, salts.
Your body needs salts to not die, sweetheart.
I don't think I'm ever gonna die. I'm immortal! I have a great idea. Why don't you just take the sugar cube and put it in a little bit of water? I'll drink it. I'll call it me juice.
Being very cute. And it's making it tempting to give you a cube. But if I give you one cube, it's gonna be an avalanche of sugar. You are a monster when it comes to food, sweetheart. You ate 9 bananas yesterday.
I know, I have not gotten in the bathroom. But when I do, it's gonna be great.
It's not gonna be great.
No,
no, it's not gonna be fun for you.
You know what?
One sugar cube into smaller pieces.
Yeah.
And eat it in pieces.
Yeah, I can eat it with a fork, like a British person. Hello, I'm eating a snack. It's the afternoon, Downton Abbey, we are going.
How do you know what that show is?
I know, because Marissa watches it with her mom.
That show's a little old for Marissa.
Marissa's very intelligent. She's in the gifted and talented program. I have another great idea. Why don't you just...
Did you take your Ritalin this morning? Be honest. Rebecca, look at me. Did you take your Ritalin? Rebecca, don't look at the sun. Stop looking at the sun. Rebecca, no! Look at me! Did you take your Ritalin this morning? Don't look at the sun! Rebecca! 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 That man's name was Rebecca!
That's right. He was a woman named Rebecca.
Over the course of this 340-minute play, we will tell you the story of Rebecca.
You know what? I was actually just popping backstage to say that I gotta get home. I gotta relieve my babies.
What? It is merely 1 in the morning. There are more secrets to be revealed about Rebecca.
I'm so sorry, and I'm really sorry to say this, but my babysitter really needs to get home.
Who's the babysitter?
Oh, her name's Claudia.
Claudia, from 6th grade. She's in the gifted and mature program.
She is in the gifted and mature
program. That's why she can babysit.
That is true. She actually is CPR certified. She took the babysitter's class.
I know. She does my teen drama camp.
Let me
give her a call for you. I will talk her in to staying on so that you can watch the last 190 minutes of the play. It's done. Siri, call Rebecca!
Claudia.
It's Rebecca! From Drama Camp! Oh, sorry, it's David Johnson from Drama Camp. You're babysitting, are you not? Extra 3 hours and 10 minutes. Your mother would love you for it. No, she's not your mother. The woman who hired you to babysit. She would be very grateful.
I'm a little sleepy.
Here's a tip. Go to the baby. Are you going to the baby?
Right now, I should go to the baby.
Yes, I'm giving you a baby tip. Go to the baby.
I'm in the foyer.
Is that where the baby is?
No, I'm walking.
Good. Babies don't go in the foyer. You should also pronounce it foyer instead of foyer.
Got it.
Grab the baby.
I'm almost in such a windy house.
Sounds like your house is wonderful. Are you going or hopping up the stairs?
I'm going the only way I know how, by lifting my knees high. Okay.
Grab the baby.
What?
Grab the baby.
Okay.
Great.
Hi.
Fall asleep on the baby. That way if the baby wakes up, you know. You'll be able to hear it. God, everything's gonna work out. Goodbye, Rebecca! This is not my phone, but I'm keeping it. That's rude. I'm sorry. There you go.
No, thank you. I'm
a bit of a drama high.
He did an encore of the play. Claudia?
I'm upstairs.
I'm in the foyer. I'll come to you.
I'll come down.
I'm coming to you.
By the way, put your money on precious hooves at the race.
Precious Hooves.
Precious Hooves?
Yeah.
This is the slowest horse we got.
No, not anymore.
Hot tip?
I gave the horse a lot of confidence.
You did? Yeah. Why'd you give it confidence?
You are the slowest horse we have. But no longer! That's all I said. Okay, great. I'm gonna take you to school, okay?
Okay.
No. I thought you, no. 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 This is harder to block than.
Rebecca.
Act 9. When we left off, we were just finishing up Rebecca's third backstory.
Born in an orphanage, and also 12, and also Portuguese. In addition to having to raise all of her siblings, and also sell herself on the streets. In additionally, also, she was a mute. Rebecca!
Rebecca! In this.
I just stopped. I'm so sorry.
Yes.
I think I'm gonna have to rock and roll.
You cannot.
I have work. I have to.
Where do you work?
I work at the stable.
Who is your boss?
Mr. Gingrich.
Mr. Gingrich, the sixth grader.
Yes, he's the sixth grader.
He's in my drama class. Give me your phone. I will make a call. Siri, Rebecca! Call Mr. Newt Gingrich. Why haven't you been to the production, by the way? I have been sending you cops.
I'm so sorry, I've got a big race coming up on Wednesday.
It's fine. Look, I have one of your employees here.
Okay. Well,
Katie did is here.
Okay.
She works at your stable. You familiar?
Yes, I know all of my employees. I'm in sixth grade and I run a stable, so I'm pretty responsible.
We're gonna need you to let her not come in for a few hours. Can I give you a horse to? Go to the horse.
All right.
Are you there?
I was right near the horse.
Great. Lie on the horse.
Okay. Okay.
Great.
What?
That's it. I don't know.
Okay, well, I'm gonna give you a tip.
Great.
Precious hooves.
Thank you for that. And it's Precious Hooves out in front. And Swirly Meatball is up in second. And followed by Barely Walking in third. Followed by Man with Hat in fourth. Followed by the Archduke of Pembroke. Followed by Mike Tyson, heavyweight champion of the world. Followed by a fire truck. Followed by a single bat. Followed by a pair of bats. Followed by Precious Hooves now in last place. Oh my goodness. Precious Hooves even behind the single bat flying around the track. Oh my God, Precious Hooves falls over. Oh no. Precious Hooves playing the piano. Precious Hooves looking seductively at the rest of the entrance. All the other entrants have stopped and they turn around on the track. They're looking back at Precious Hooves. Precious Hooves calls her shot. merely have a frowny face. They said I could not direct anymore. What?
This is terrible.
What? What friend's house?
her friend Janet's house.
Janet Reno, I know her. She is in my sixth grade class. She does my drama camp every summer. Not by choice. Give me your phone.
I'm really close to being out of batteries.
Oh, 2%, we can make it happen. Siri, call Janet Reno. There's no time to yell, Rebecca!
I have a judgment to make. Me, Janet Reno. Oh, my phone is ringing. Hello?
Hello, Judge Janet Reno.
Yes.
It is I, director actor David Johnson.
what's
can
up?
Can you stay at the friend's house? Can your friend stay at your house? I have her mother here in my play. She must stay and kill herself.
I'll have to ask my parents.
Go to your friend. Go to the friend.
What should I do?
Are you at the friend?
Yes, I am.
Lie on it.
You know what? You enjoyed this?
Mm-hmm.
Let me give you a house of cards. Step up. It's the BBC version, so it's dry. But you will. If you like spying, get ready for it.
Okay, thanks.
Okay.
I appreciate it.
Great, and that's the only VHS tag.